Imagine. Imagine yourself not feeling any pain, not feeling any suffering, but feeling good, feeling free in your mind. Imagine yourself floating in the air with your arms out like an eagle, and you're flying around, and everywhere you see there are people, and their people are smiling, and everyone is having a good time, and the people are loving one another, sharing with one another. Imagine a world where there's only peace, where there's no anger, where there's no hate, where there's no war. Imagine a world that is full of nothing but love and full of nothing but joy. This world is something that we need.
Are you happy? I guess everyone has got their own lessons. Few things still need to be looked after.
What is it? Just tell me.
Being the earth, I am called the mother. I am the lady, a girl. But this is not the case in many areas. Girls are becoming the victim of the cruel world knowingly or unknowingly. If you really want to know the pain, then see this.
छोटी सी आशा छोटा सा छोटी सी आशा मस्ती भरे मन की भोली सी आशा चांद तारों को छूने की आशा आसमानों में उड़ने की आशा दिल है छोटा सा छोटी सी आशा मस्ती भरे मन की भोली सी आशा
बहू मुझे लड़का ही चाहिए।
माँ 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 अभी तो भगवान ने मेरे हाथों पे किस्मत की लकीरें भी नहीं बनाई और उनसे पहले ही आप सबने मेरी तकदीर का फैसला सुना दिया। माँ मुझे जी लेने दो, अपनी कसम मैं आपको कभी तंग नहीं करूंगी। माँ मैं भैया की किताबों से अपने आप ही पढ़ लिख जाऊंगी और हाँ पापा मेरी स्कूल फीस की चिंता मत करना, बस ये कहना मेरे दहेज की चिंता ना करे, मैं आपके साथ रहकर आपके बुढ़ापे का सहारा बनूंगी। अगर फिर भी आपको लगता है कि मैं आप पर बोझ बनूंगी तो आप इस ऑपरेशन पर भी खर्चा मत करना, मैं ही भगवान जी से कह दूंगी कि मेरी माँ मेरा मरा मुंह देखे।
Half of India's children are girls. However, the girl child is considered a lesser child in our society, irrespective of class, caste, and economic conditions. She is discriminated against and neglected at all the levels. This results in the denial of basic services required for her survival, welfare, and development. The girl child is perceived as a burden to be passed on to another family. Her contribution in the household economy is not acknowledged. I deeply wish that girl child in India be treated equally with the male child. Do not discriminate the girl child in our country. Let us make a promise to educate the girl child and save them from discrimination.
Kya soch rahi ho? Ghar chale? नन्ही परी के स्वागत की तैयारियां भी तो करनी है ना। चलो।
कोख को कबर ना बनाए, खुशी खुशी बिटिया को दुनिया में लाए।
Let's take this moment to see how the academic year has certainly been. It has been filled with varied activities and motivating competitions along with the academics. We now have the voiceover of our chairman, Mr. Jesus Lal, verbalizing all that the students of SilverOak Universal School have accomplished, right from our budding toddlers at Oakwood Universal School, our enthusiastic achievers of the primary and middle school at Sharanpur, and our go-getters of the secondary section at Chandsi. So here we have the annual report of the academic year 2012-2013.
Dear parents, it gives me great pleasure to welcome you to our annual day this evening and to present to you the annual report of SilverOak Universal School, Nasik, for the year 2012 and 13. This year was remarkable in many ways. It was the year that stirred us to scale new peaks, led us to learn new lessons, and propelled us to a new pinnacle of achievements. Driven by our unquenched thirst for excellence, we worked harder to move towards bigger goals. At SilverOak Universal, every child is engaged in mastering a holistic set of skills that make good our promise to create a lifelong learner. theme-based and linked knowledge, when wedded to attitudes and values, makes learning meaningful and socially responsible. We aspire to give our students this unique gift. The school embraced the theme, Global Citizenship, Better World Through Better People. The focus was on the vision, values, and culture within the school and its part in the world through shared responsibilities and collaboration. In keeping with the dictum, well begun is half done, we flagged off the year with an orientation program for the teachers conducted by the director and the counseling and research head. Awareness of the responsibilities and code of conduct for the teachers were delineated. Teachers were urged to utilize their knowledge, experience, and innovation to harness the potential and capabilities of the students entrusted to them. An orientation program for the parents was conducted in the month of June. Rules, regulations, and evaluation patterns for the academic year were explained. A detailed class-wise orientation was designed to ensure that our parents were on the same page on the academic program. I would like to take this opportunity to thank our parents for their continual trust and support for the school. Our counseling and research department continues to spread awareness on mental health to teachers, students, and parents. The life skill classes and counseling sessions have offered immense relief to children with special needs. We took another step towards systematic and organized functioning of the school.